Hello, I'm Mr. R. Napier, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. I'm going to tackle a very important parable, which is parable of wheat, plants and tares, Matthew 13:24-30. But before I tackle that one, I would like to give a discourse on the Kingdom of Heaven and the Royal Kingdom of God. So Kingdom of Heaven is different from the Royal Kingdom of God. Many people don't appreciate that one. They don't have any idea what Kingdom of Heaven is and what is the Kingdom of Royal Kingdom of God is. So this will become clear on this table, which is of in Adam and God. Now, John the Baptist, he was a prophet Elijah in the name of Adam. Adam deals with our flesh, outward, tribal identity and race, and the tribal people are born, tribal people die. So the priest that gave the moral education to the people looks after their interest that they live in peace. They don't fight with each other. So he keeps the justice in the society. So justice then will bring peace. When you have peace, you say it is there, like living in heaven. But when there is fighting and people are killing each other, as you see them today in Jerusalem, or in Sri Lanka, or in other parts of the world where sectarian riots are taking place, that those are called hell. So the rabbi, he used to give them the moral education, and when the rabbi was honest and good, you know, he kept a good law and order. He would not do any favor to anybody, so everything will be just. So, no biased are doing any favor, as these people are doing today in Jerusalem. Remember that in Jerusalem, when these Gentiles used to come visit this temple, they used to fleece them, rob them of their money. And when they robbed them of their money, then they used to go to St. James the Just, tell them that, oh, this thing has happened to them. And all the just people in Jerusalem, they were dependent upon St. James the Just. So St. James the Just will go to the house of the person who has cheated, so tell him, you know, to beg him to return his money back. So he should not be overcharging or should not be fleecing them. So by putting him to shame, he used to get the money out from him and return it to the Gentile. So this way, St. James the Just was preaching that in God there is no Gentile or Jew. In God we are equal. There is no superiority. But the Jews, they had got a notion of superiority over the Gentile. And that they used to despise Gentile. And that the Samaritan woman in John 4 at the well, then when Jesus asked for water, she said, "You Jews, you hate us, and you asked me to give you water." So that was the summary of the situation at that time. So when you have law and order, because when it's law and order, is your flesh, is your body that lives in peace, no fighting, no killing, and you have enjoyed the peace in society. So when you enjoy the peace in society, it is called heaven. So when these rabbis, they were of God, and they did not use to do favor, treated everybody equally as Saint James the Just was doing, or as Prophet Elijah, John the Baptist was doing, then there was law and order, and it was like heaven. So that's what we call the key to the kingdom of heaven was given to the rabbis, but in this dark age, they become corrupt. They become money-minded. They start living in big palaces. Remember John the Baptist? He was living in the wilderness, and that is why where they should be living. And that's why it's in our rabbinic system, or a Levi is not supposed to own immovable property. That means he should be detached from the secular wealth. Then he is devoted to God. So, then these rabbis, they became corrupt, money-minded, and start robbing people or cheating people in the name of religion, as the example was of widow's mite. Even that widow put her mite into the temple in good faith, but temple priest was using that money to live lavishly. So they were fleecing the simple-minded people. So when they become corrupt, then they start doing favors to the people, then the injustice come. With the injustice, there is a trouble in the world, in the people. So people are not happy. So Jerusalem was the center of this trouble, whereas in the villages, people are living in a good law and order, and they were enjoying heaven. So the village priest, especially of the Gentile, they kept law and order, and they had the key to the kingdom of heaven. As in the Samaritan woman was a good example, that it was that Levi priest of that village who prepared those people, clean-hearted, white crop that Jesus reaped or he harvested. That is why Jesus said somebody else sown it and somebody else has come to reap them. So that's when the kingdom of heaven became corrupt and the priest became corrupt, no law and order, then the royal priest of God comes. So when he comes, he brings in the royal kingdom of God. Now what applies to flesh, the opposite applies to spirit. The kingdom of heaven is outside in the world, which you can see with your two naked eyes in law and order. Whereas the kingdom of royal kingdom of God is opposite, is within your own heart. It's not outside, it's your own heart. When you get cheated, when you get fleeced, you get fed up. Then you only have the solace or the comfort in the word of God. So when you have the solace or the comfort in the word of God, then your mind is at peace. So when your mind at peace, then you know these people are crook, and whosoever will do wrong thing, he will suffer. So this is the age of conscience. So in conscience, people are paid. So then the royal kingdom of God is brought in by the royal priest of God. So Jesus brings in this kingdom which is within our heart, and that is known through the qualities of the person, how he treats others. And so this is the kingdom of heaven, this is the royal kingdom of God. And Jesus is the royal kingdom of God, is for your own peace of mind, not to show it. This extrinsic value, this is intrinsic value. inside you. And God bless you.